will be compiled. What is the output of compiler?
Lut module.
Object course.
Object module.
Object module. And what is the output of this one is?
Load module.
Load module. Load module will be stored in PDS. If you see this program, its program is IGYCRCTL. Okay, program is it's a system program, IGYCRCTL. Here the program is, I think, IEWL. These are provided by IBM. So what compiler does, compiler is going to check the syntax. Compiler is going to check the syntax, and we have written program in English, and this English level language will be converted to machine level language. And this machine level language will be finally converted into an executable version. A load module can be compared to an EXE. This is a normal compiler where COBOL source code is compiled and a load module is created. And what is the use of link edit step? Link edit step is going to combine all the load modules. For example, you write call COBOL to DLI, right? It's a load module. It's a call statement. It's like it's a static call. So it is going to combine all the statically called load modules in this link edit steps. Syntax errors will be checked here. Here link edit, the load modules will be combined here. So if you take a COBOL DB2 source, which is having SQL. Okay, SQL statements cannot be compiled using this compiler, this program. So what IBM brought, they brought in a step called pre-compiler, before compiler. It is writing step on its own. So IBM introduced a pre-compiler step. Okay, before compiler. So since this compiler doesn't understand SQL statements, in pre-compiler what it does, it is going to comment out all the SQL code in pre-compiler. So it is going to create two outputs. One is commented out COBOL source code with commented SQL statements. Okay, commented SQL statements, and it is going to replace, it is going to introduce a lot of additional replaced with some move on call statements. If we tell this, that is enough. COBOL source code with commented SQL statements and replaced with move on call statements. Since the SQL statement cannot be compiled by IGYCRCTL, here this program is DSN HPC. This is the program name. This is a pre-compiler. Pre-compiler is going to create two outputs. One output is COBOL source code with commented SQL replaced with moon call statement. Next output is, what is the next output?
DBRM module, sir.
DBRM. So DBRM stands for database request module. Okay. So what it does, apart from creating these two outputs, it is going to attach a timestamp because this belongs to this. So it is going to attach a timestamp. So it is going to attach a timestamp. So this COBOL DBRM can be called as a compiled version of SQL. Okay, we can call it as an object module of SQL. This is not executable. So if you want to execute this, what you have to do? You have to create an executable version of SQL statement, which is nothing but a plan. So plan, this is the executable version of COBOL source code. Okay, load module is executable version of COBOL source code and this is the executable exe files, executable version of SQL statements. So all SQL statements alone will be compiled and created a plan, and this step is bind step. The bind is going to convert a DBRM into a plan. The bind program is PGM IKJEF T01. It's a system program. Okay, so here what precompiler does. See, precompiler, what it's going to do, apart from commenting the SQL statement and it is going to create these two outputs, it is going to check for basic syntax errors in SQL. Basically, it is going to compare, okay, it is going to compare the DCSN copybook, okay, versus SQL queries. So what you have given in SQL queries, you are giving select, insert, update, delete, and fetch, and open, close. So it is going to compare whether the column name in DCSN copybook is matching, whether it is defined, whether table name is matching, whether cursor name is correct. So it is going to compare, have the basic check. It is going to compare the variables declared in working storage section with the variables used in the variables used in procedure division. Okay, or I'll write only in SQL. So SQL variables in working storage compared with variables used in queries. Queries means procedure division by default. I'll write like this. So this is what this does. Any company, any error, it is going to show here. Precompiler should be zero, but precompiler should be zero. Compiler can be zero or four. So in project, everything should be zero. Then what bind does? So bind connects to DB2 subsystem. Okay. It is going to check whether the data table is present or not. The table you have mentioned. Then it is going to verify the column names, whether it is already created. It is going to verify the authority. Authority means the access. Suppose you are trying to insert a table, insert a column in a table. So you need to have access, otherwise you cannot insert. So it is going to check authority. And finally, it is going to create an access strategy. Access strategy to execute the query efficiently. So as far as a file is concerned, okay, say take a VSAM file, we are going to mention what is the access mode, sequential or random. If it is PS, just sequential. Sequential means going to read sequentially. Random means random mode. Random means it will go to index component, check the address, come back to data component, locate the address, locate the record. So as far as DB2 is concerned, we don't mention how we are going to access. The access mode is not mentioned. We just write the queries. It decides how to access. It could be, okay, there could be any indexes in your database. For example, if you write, you can create as many indexes for database. You can create more than 1,000 also. There'll be only one primary index, primary key. There'll be only one unique index, but there could be many secondary indexes. Okay, so you can just create indexes. It is going to create which is the best. It is going to use whatever indexes it wants based on the query it has written and create an access strategy. Okay, assume you are having a book, a big book, 1000 pages book. Okay, I could be, say it is 2000, 4000 pages book, a big binder, and you have many indexes A, B, C, D, E till Z. Indexes, each index is different. Each index, okay, is different. Suppose if you want to search, you can use one or two indexes. It could be one index or two index, or going to use multiple indexes, and finally to locate the page number and read. Similarly, a database can have a single primary index, and there could be many secondary index. So we are just going to write the query. We are not going to say how it is going to be accessed. The efficient accessing is going to be decided by bind step. That's why bind is very important step. Okay, it is going to create an access strategy. If you take an Amazon, if you take Amazon for the item table, whichever you are accessing, item number is the unique primary index. Okay, whatever you are searching is going to be secondary index. There could be hundreds of secondary index. It could be up to 1000 also. I'm not sure. There could be hundreds of index, and may not be 1000, but could be hundreds of secondary index. So we are just writing a query, meaning we are searching Amazon for some product based on some features. It is going to based on whatever you have selected, it is going to decide which indexes are going to be used so that the record is fetched very, very quickly for you. Okay, this is nothing but the access strategy. So this takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of CPU time. That's why bind is very expensive. The bind is very expensive because it is going to take a lot of CPU time. Yesterday for one batch, I told you about blockchain, right? In blockchain, it is going to take a lot of time if you are going to do data mining in blockchain. So any doubts on this? Up to this? Yes or no?
No, sir.
Why are you so sad?
After lunch, no, sir.
That's why. Okay. So this is a very important question. Even if it's 10 years, 15 years experience in mainframe, so this is a very important question. Remember, if you are answering this properly, assume this is the first question, if you are answering properly, then the interviewer is going to have very good impression. Okay, I'll explain again. There are four steps involved. The first step is pre-compiler. It is going to take COBOL source code as input. It is going to create two outputs, COBOL source code with commented SQL and replace with move and call statement along with timestamp. Here DBRM it's timestamp. It is going to do this check, basic check, like comparing the SQL variables. Okay, it is going to compare from working storage with the procedure division, and if there is an error, it is going to show here. And then compiler, it's going to compile this source code, check the syntax, and compile, create an object model, and then this is going to convert this to a load model, which is the executable version of source code, COBOL source code. A DBRM is not executable, it's an object model of SQL. It is again compiled and we create a plan. Plan is stored in DB2 directory. It's not stored in any PDS. It's a centralized repository for everyone. That's why plan name should be unique. Okay, if your trainer is told to use unique plan names, because all the plan names are going to be stored in one place. In DB2 subsystem, here it is DBAG, and that's the reason it should be unique. If there is a duplicate, if one person compiles in a name, another person compiles with same name, the second one is going to replace the first plan. That's why it should be unique. And what bind does? Bind is a very important step. As a part of bind, we are going to pass parameters like isolation level, They are going to pass acquire and release parameters, etc. All these are passed in bind parameter. It is going to convert DBRM to plan. It is going to do all these. Connects to DBD subsystem, check whether table is present, column names are present, the authority is, you have authority to do the operation, and finally the access strategy to execute the query efficiently. And this access strategy will be stored in many tables. Okay, many tables. And if you want to know the access strategy, there's a utility called explain. If you execute that access, explain utility, you'll be able to see the access strategy. But that is, right now it's okay. This is, if you know this, it is enough. Any doubts on this? Bind is, if you can take a screenshot, it's a very, very important interview question. So make sure you're thorough. That's why I've drawn a little bit legibly. Okay. So let me tell you about package. So you should, here in training, what we have done, a program A, program B, program say Z. A program A has one plan, right? P say plan A. This is plan B. Plan Z. Okay, this is what we are doing in training. So since bind plan is very expensive and you are supposed to do a bind plan every time when you change the program, so in project what we do, we used to share the plans. For all these 26 programs, we'll share with only one plan. So instead what we do, we give a package, okay, for every program. So PGM A, PGM B, and PGM Z. So package A, package B, and package Z. So these, we are going to have packages, not plans. So we can compile any number of times so that we are not going to waste system resources. So what this package will be done, so we are, instead of doing converting a DBRM into plan, we are going to convert DBRM into package, not the plan. So and we used to call as a bind package. Bind package means converting DBRM to package. Bind plan means converting DBRM into plan. So what admin will do, so this is programmer. Okay, programmer will be doing this. We are doing this. What admin will do? He is going to combine all the package into a plan. Using another program, system program, will be combined to a plan. Plan A. So it's a common plan for all the packages. This is to avoid to use plan very efficiently, because plan is going to take a lot of time, it's a big program which is going to create the access strategy. So we should not write the access strategy every time. So better to, what we do, this is done by administrator and we use only package. So package is not executable. Okay, only plan is executable. I'll come back to the previous screen. So here, this is the compilation process. How are you going to execute? You're going to execute which one? You're going to execute the load module. Right, the program. When you're executing the load module, how the program is executed in COBOL, line by line. Very simple, line by line from procedure division. So when it goes to the SQL statement, still SQL statement will not be there. SQL will not be there. SQL load will not be there. It will see the call statement. This call statement is going to bring the plan from the DB2 directory, okay, and then into memory, main memory, and then execute the plan. So to execute any COBOL DB2 program, we need two load modules. One is a load module of the COBOL program, and next one is the plan. We need exe version of COBOL as well as the SQL. Both these are required. That's why we give both these as parameters in your DB2 run. Then your DB2 run JSL, we give load module and plan, because both are required. It's a compiled or version of or executable version of SQL. This is the executable version of a load module. And we are going to execute this. It is going to execute line by line. Whenever it encounters the SQL statement, it is going to bring a plan and then execute the plan. So plan is executable. Nothing else is executable here. Now let me get into package. So in package is not executable. Okay, package is not executable. So what we do when we are compiling, we are going to create a package. Okay, in DB2 compilation JCL, in the pre-compilation and bind step, we are going to bind into a package. But while running the JCL, DB2 run, we are going to use the plan. Okay, this you ought to know. So while compiling, okay, create package. And while executing, we have to use planning, because package is not executable. And if you execute this plan, anyway, it's connected to the package. Okay, if you execute this plan, it's connected to the package. Is it fine? So package is not executable, and a collection of packages will have a collection ID. Okay, a group of packages call a collection. This is also another keyword they use, a group of packages. And this is done by administrator, not for programmer. It's a collection. Collection will have collection ID. For example, based on the application. Claims application will have a collection ID, and policy application will have a collection ID, something like that. This is for easy maintenance by the administrator. So package, and whenever you change a program, they will ask, somebody will be asking this question. If you change a program, what are you supposed to do? We have to say we are going to compile the program and create the new package, but we are not going to create a new plan. Plan is already linked to a package. So we are not going to create a plan again. This is a common interview question. If you're going to change the program, do we need to create the plan again? You have to say no. But periodically they do a plan. They do a bind plan. So this is also called bind plan, where it converts package to a plan, links all the packages into a plan. Okay, this is what we have done in training, and this is how we'll be doing in projects. For every program, we'll be compiling into a package. We have to know this package is linked to which plan. Then for executing, we have to use plan name, not the package name. We have to use plan name as well as the load module name. Plan and load module. That is of COBOL source code. So any doubts on this? This is a very important interview question about bind plan, package, etc. Package, what is pre-compiler? And they'll be asking this question in any manner. They'll ask what is the compilation procedure, pre-compilation procedure, can you explain about bind process, can you explain about package creation process, plan process, whatever, okay? But all these are same question. But this is a very common interview question.